On Thursday, August 23rd, more than 70 artists, writers, and community leaders, people closely tied to the creative economy, gathered for a forum at the Bennington Museum to discuss how this segment of the state's economy was doing and how it might be leveraged further. Sometimes described as the intersection of arts, culture, innovation, and commerce, it has received increasing attention over the past decade as not just an indicator of cultural richness, but also as a provider of a significant number of jobs and economic impact. In Vermont, it plays a role in drawing visitors and tourists to the state. According to the Vermont Creative Network, which was established by the state legislature in 2016 to boost the sector further, more than 28,000 jobs in the state were directly tied to the creative economy as of 3 years ago. Wendy Knight, the commissioner of the Vermont Department of Tourism and Marketing and one of the guest speakers of the event, described its reach and impact.
Well, what we see is that people come to Vermont because of the authenticity. So Vermont has a very authentic experience, and more travelers want to visit a destination as a not as a visitor, but as a local, and in sort of that authentic experience. And I think that they find that here in Vermont. I think that what really I find inspiring about the Vermont Creative Network is that they define the creatives and the creative economy broader than just a painter, for example. And so whether it's the visual arts or the performing arts, but it's beyond that. It's a graphic designer, it's someone that's creating a company, it's someone that might be, you know, the arts in the way of artisans, right? So you have food art, and you have people that are making raw milk, artisans cheese, and craft distilleries, and I think that's a whole the whole of that makes the creative economy in Vermont, and that's exactly what people come to Vermont for. So it's not just going to an art gallery or a performance at the Dorset Theater, but it's really experiencing that creativity. It's expressed in various ways in Vermont.
The event built on the Bennington Museum's summer exhibition titled The New Deal, Crash to Creativity, which featured art made in and about Vermont during the Depression of the 1930s and the role of the Federal Works Project Administration in helping artists survive economically while documenting the period in U.S. history. Robert Woltersdorf, the director of the Bennington Museum, told the audience about what he saw as the impact of the museum on the local economy beyond its artistic mission.
Economic activity is the most obvious thing we bring to Bennington, but I would argue that the less tangible aspects are even more important. We make this a more livable, rich, and enjoyable place to live for you, your partner, your children, your employees, the recruits you're trying to lure here to work at your new business. It's a great place to start a business as a result.
After several speakers had held forth on different aspects of growing the creative economy within the state, they assembled as a panel and took questions, including one which asked about growing the brand by being welcoming to artists and creatives from outside Vermont.
What do you think, if I'm right about that, then what does that do to our ability to grow the creative economy? How do we let people in from other places?
Unless you're Abnaki, you're not native. We are all immigrants. So it's something we definitely struggle with. And when you think about Vermont, we are a lot of us from elsewhere, and that's good because we need to grow Vermont both internally in terms of encouraging younger folks that are from Vermont. My man is a seventh generation Vermonter, and he went away and came back, and so we want more of those individuals too. And I think it comes with the tension of thinking that we are open and welcoming, and that's part of our brand, and that's part of who we promote ourselves. And then we have situations where there's racial slurs thrown at people that are from out of state, or there's swastikas, or there's this Native Son t-shirt that you see. So for me, it's about coming together as communities and reminding ourselves that we are a welcoming place and that we need to embrace all kinds of people.
Matthew Perry, the executive director of the Vermont Arts Exchange in North Bennington and one of the organizers of the meeting, stressed the importance of partnerships between the business community and the arts community as the best way forward.
Sort of forums like this where everybody's coming together and first of all acknowledging it, you know, the businessmen, in the same room with the artists in the same room with town municipalities, town managers, economic development people, institutions, kind of like, you know, the Putnam Hotel project. It's a partnership, a conglomeration of the hospital and the schools, the colleges, and private and public funding. And I think, you know, that's the way things are working. And certainly with the Vermont Arts Exchange for 25 years, we've built up our work on partnerships.
For the GNAT-TV News Project, I'm Andrew McKeever.